everyone deserves a right to have this deeply human connection to nature. It's a part of who we are, and it's a part of what we need. I spent over 20 years living in Colorado and Montana, being in the Rocky Mountains. And then about 8 years ago, my family moved to Washington, D.C. And I kind of felt like the stress bomb went off in my brain. I felt more anxious. I had trouble sleeping. I felt depressed. The noises of urban life started to really bother me. And I began to really think about the ways our external landscape gets reflected in our internal emotional landscape. It made me really curious about what the science had to say about why we feel different in different environments. The science very strongly supports the notion that our nervous systems calm down when we're in a natural setting. Our respiration slows, our heart rate slows down, our stress hormones change. It made me really understand nature as kind of a human right. People who don't have that kind of regular access to nature are really at a disadvantage. And so I think for people who grow up in cities, it kind of exhausts us and fatigues us in ways that we don't even understand, that are just subconscious. Our sort of amygdala, parts of our brains that process fear, they really light up when there's a loud rumbling sound. It was very handy for us when we lived around large carnivores. But now that we live in urban neighborhoods and places where there are loud noises, it actually can really affect us over the long term in terms of our anxiety levels. We're living in incredibly challenging times right now. Even before the pandemic, the trends were going in the wrong direction. There was a lot of disconnection, a lot of loneliness, high rates of anxiety and depression, especially in younger people. It's times like these when being alone in nature can be incredibly powerful. I think in all of us, there's a really deeply evolved connection to nature. But I think for a lot of us, maybe we haven't been lucky enough to exercise that connection. If you ask grown-ups how they define nature, they tend to say, oh, a national park, oh, a mountain trail. But if you ask a child how they define nature, they will say, oh, it's the caterpillar on my sidewalk. It's the tree on the street. They have a much more generous view of nature. They know how to find it. They know how to experience awe and wonder. We tend to think of awe as being this like really big, powerful, you know, top of the mountain experience. And I think that's a mistake. I think we can learn to recognize moments of awe and moments of beauty in our everyday lives. We can microdose awe. And when we do that, it's incredibly powerful and truly grounding.